keeping. A story true and genuine. And I have not the candid heart to keep its burden clandestine. For its gravity is as weighty as a mountain capped in snow. And its memory repeats inside of me, ostinato. And every time I think of the polar, I recall the fear upon their faces and the doomed fate of them all. I saw death become of light and life become of fire. I saw it from my hiding place within the quagmire. I bringeth forth the drama, unabridged and unignored, the battle of the Balrog and the mighty lightning.
Lord of lightning shifts his gaze, points his strong finger.
Lights up a carnival of paint. I endeavor to watch the panic, but I worry that I will faint.
Floating fire, golden wire, silver trails, flashing spire. Guns are cracking, bombs are smacking, cannibal tails, whips are lashing. Lord of lightning's closer now.
From the Lord's electric snare, one goes in his electric chair.
Leaves destruction.
luckless hostage has been thoroughly fried. Began to twitch at my great surprise. Then the figure sprung up, and at once it caught a light, and the creature known as Balrog was born that very night. He's fixed on us as him ignored. Sneak a glimpse at its expression, and beyond the flames, a searing smoke at our present depression. I fear that God's a chef, and he's thrown us into a great pot. He is here, fully formed, and glowing red and lapis hot.
He did madness, come to gouge the heart.
Laid out is the burnt path his faith, and so the damned remaining lot knelt before the red behemoth. And as they prepared for afterlife, there appeared the endemic monstrosity. The lightning lord was back and charged the Balrog animosity. Furious, he pummeled his breast and a blaze alit the heavens. The stage was set for war, and to the Balrog, the lord's finger beckoned. This altered world.